Hello everyone, today I will use a genetic algorithm to approximate the sine curve using a polynomial equation. So first of all, what is a genetic algorithm? A genetic algorithm is a search heuristic that is inspired by Darwin's theory of natural evolution. This algorithm reflects the process of natural selection where the fittest individuals are selected for reproduction in order to produce offspring of the next generation. First, I have included the required libraries. Next, I have defined a function to calculate the output of the polynomial equation. It returns the sum of the coefficients multiplied by the input raised to its corresponding power. Then I have defined a function to print the genes, which are basically the coefficients in our model. And a test function which prints the output for a given input. Here I have defined the hyperparameters. Mutation is a genetic operator used to maintain genetic diversity from one generation to the next. Mutation alters one or more gene values in a chromosome from its initial state. Next, I have scanned the number of genes and incremented it by 1. Since coefficients of a polynomial equation is 1 more than the degree of the equation. Here I have taken n samples of the sine waves separated by equal intervals. Next, I have initialized the population with random genes and it is normalized such that higher powers of x have lower coefficients. In this loop, I am calculating the root mean squared loss and printing it every 1000 generations. Then I have sorted the chromosomes based on the loss. I have used a simple selection sort, but it can be done more efficiently. I am updating the plot of the equations every 1000 generations. Then I am forming the next generation using the best chromosomes. Two chromosomes are randomly chosen from the best ones. The resulting chromosomes will have the genes value equal to either of its parents or the average of both. There is also a probability of the gene being mutated by some random amount. The rest of the code is to update or view the model during runtime. Now let's run it. Let's begin with a cubic model. You can see the various type of cubic curves that are evolved to pass through these three given points. You can also view the model coefficients. I hope you liked it.